Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 106 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 182 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 183. Question 183. You plan to deploy 3 Azure virtual machines named VM1, VM2 and VM3. The virtual machines will host a web app named App1. You need to ensure that at least 2 virtual machines are available if a single Azure data center becomes unavailable. What should you deploy? Before we answer this question, let's understand the concept of availability zone and availability set. We are on availability sets overview page in learn.microsoft.com. We'll scroll down. What is an availability set? Availability sets are logical groupings of virtual machines that reduce the chance of correlated failures, bringing down related virtual machines at the same time. Availability sets place virtual machines in different fault domains for better reliability, especially beneficial if a region doesn't support availability zones. When using availability sets, create 2 or more virtual machines within an availability set. Using 2 or more virtual machines in availability set helps highly available applications and meet the 99.95% Azure SLA. Further, there is no extra cost for using availability sets. How do availability sets work? Each virtual machine in your availability set is assigned an update domain and a fault domain by the underlying Azure platform. Each availability set can be configured with up to 3 fault domains and 20 update domains. These configurations can't be changed once the availability set has been created. This is very important. Keep in mind 3 fault domains and 20 update domains. Let's try to understand the availability set from this diagram. We do have 3 fault domains, fault domain 0, fault domain 1 and fault domain 2 in this availability set. Virtual machines under one fault domain have common power supply and network connectivity. So it has common power and network connectivity. Virtual machines under fault domain 1 have common power supply and network connectivity. Similarly, virtual machines in fault domain 2 have common power supply and network connectivity. Again, the update domain is a logical grouping of virtual machines which can be restarted together. So, for example, UD1 is one group and this virtual machine is the member of UD1. Similarly, the virtual machine in fault domain 2 is the member of UD1. Therefore, always there will be some virtual machines running in each fault domain. Now, let's understand about availability zone. We are on what are availability zones page. Many Azure regions provide availability zones, which are separated groups of data centers within a region. Availability zones are closed enough to have low latency connections to other availability zones. They are connected by high performance network with a round trip latency of less than 2 milliseconds. However, availability zones are far enough apart to reduce the likelihood that more than one will be affected by local outages or weather. Availability zones have independent power, cooling, and networking infrastructure. They are designed so that if one zone experiences an outage, then regional services capacity and high availability are supported by the remaining zones. Let's understand in this diagram. So we do have Azure region 1 and having multiple availability zone in it. So availability zone 1, availability zone 2 and availability zone 3 are the member of Azure region 1. Each availability zone may have one or more data centers in it. Therefore, if we host virtual machines separately in each availability zone, it will ensure that whenever we do have one of the data center down in any of the availability zone, remaining two are up and running, making sure that application is accessible from other availability zones. Let's go back to question. We need to make sure that at least two virtual machines are available if a single Azure data center becomes unavailable. Therefore, we will have to place virtual machines in three availability zones so that any of the availability zone data center is down, other two virtual machines are up and running. Option A, all three virtual machines in single availability zone. If three of three virtual machines are in single availability zone and then that availability zone goes down, all three virtual machines will go down. Therefore, this answer is incorrect. Option B, all virtual machines in single availability set. Availability set is composed of fault domains and update domains, and all the fault domains and update domains reside in the same data center. Therefore, if data center goes down, this all virtual machines running in the fault domain and update domain will go down. Therefore, this is the incorrect answer. Option D, each virtual machine in separate availability set. Availability sets are logical grouping of the virtual machines in the same data center. Therefore, all the virtual machine will go down when data center goes down. Therefore, option C, each virtual machine in separate availability zone is the correct answer, making sure that if one availability zone goes down, rest two availability zones are available because their data centers are separate. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.